It's like, Chris, okay, Coos, this one could have gone a completely different direction. Nets could have won going away, but the Timberwolves made things tight, close, and the Nets had to pull it out in a nail biter. What's your big takeaway from this game?
The reminder and the constant reminder that we have gotten that every team and every opponent will bring their best shot against this Brooklyn Nets team. And it's something that through the development and the learning lessons are a whole lot easier when it's a win at the end of the day. But you saw a Minnesota Timberwolves team that continued to play hard. They took advantage of their strengths, which was crashing the offensive glass, generating some points off turnovers, and did just enough in stretches to continue to put pressure on this Nets defense. It's an area, of course, that we have talked about quite a bit. But overall, closing time continues to belong to Brooklyn. And when you look at areas to get better, James Harden even told you in his on-court interview, he's coming away with 38 points, 13 assists, 11 rebounds. And what does he point to? The turnovers. He had too many turnovers. That's too many for a point guard for him orchestrating a team. So I think everyone on this Brooklyn Nets team understands that there's areas to improve, ways they've got to get better and clean up. But it's a whole lot easier to look at those things, look at the film, when you still get the W.
Such an efficient offensive team, the Nets. When they're getting a shot on goal, and guys have told me this, they feel like when they get a shot on goal, it's going to be a high percentage look. So they have to take care of the basketball. She pointed out James Harden mentioned in that post-game. He had a masterful game, though. What did you see from Kyrie Irving after missing the three games this past week and then returning tonight?
First of all, he was locked in to start this game, and we saw that in efficiency, the quickness of his movements, how he was playing, where he was finding his shots. And I think it is fair to assume that anyone who's missing a couple games, not getting that type of run, that maybe by the end of the game he was feeling a little bit in his legs, could have been some of the reason why his shots stopped falling towards the latter part of the game. But Kyrie Irving continues to impress on the offensive end, how he plays, his feel and understanding for the game. And it just changes the dynamic of what we see on the floor when he brings that type of potency offensively.
Timberwolves, worst record in the league. Coming up on Wednesday, the Houston Rockets, second worst record in the league. An opportunity for James Harden to face his former team once again.
Yeah, and for the Nets, again, an opportunity to test themselves against a team of a lesser record that is still going to come in and play hard. And you can guarantee that Houston will do so. They've had a lot of movement and changes in their roster, just given injuries and who's been available and not. But overall, this has been a theme for Brooklyn, that regardless of opponent, it's been about them, and it's been about what they need to do to continue to improve their game. And I think it's going to be another example of that against a Houston team that certainly will come in motivated and come in hungry.
We'll be back here at Barclays Center. Birdman, Ian Eagle will be on the call alongside Sarah Kustot. Looking forward to that. 7 o'clock coverage will start at 7:30. The tip right here on ESPN. We'll send it back to you in the studio.